My name is Peter Gilbert. I'm the Executive Director of the Vermont Humanities Council. Two state humanities councils will introduce each of today's three panels, but that doesn't mean that the programs of those councils are largely related to the themes that their panel will explore. That is, my counterpart from Rhode Island and I organized this panel related to public humanities' potential to enhance K-12 education and lifelong learning. But our councils offer programs related to all three panels. Yes, Vermont's council offers signature programs that enhance K-12 education, such as our statewide one-book community reading program called Vermont Reads, which each year encourages both students and schools and townspeople in about 65 to 100 communities to read the same book and take part in myriad related activities. Yes, Vermont's council offers a variety of programs that further lifelong learning specifically, including First Wednesdays, the highest quality lecture series that happens monthly in 9 community libraries simultaneously in every region of the state. We think of it as New York City's 92nd Street Y comes to Vermont. But the Vermont Council has also been a pioneer in public humanities program related to literacy. As in other states, public humanities programs in Vermont improve and even change the lives of tens of thousands of people, and each year in Vermont help 150 towns both pursue positive goals and confront some of the challenges that all American communities face. I would emphasize that public humanities programs in the areas of K-12 and lifelong learning are more important than ever because education, more than ever, involves not just schools, but their communities and the larger social context. If society doesn't honor learning and encourage curiosity, it's hard for schools to succeed. If learning stops when formal schooling stops, then the knowledge and understanding of America's workforce and citizenry will be inadequate by any measure. Because even the best schools could never possibly teach everything that students and citizens should know, society should do all it can to promote good schools and lifelong learning through public programs such as those of state humanities councils, public libraries, and quality programs on the web, TV, and radio.
Thank you.